Good morning, welcome to another Energy Flows. And what's the state of the world today? What's the energy that's up? Well, let's follow the energy and have a look-see. Hi, Tanya. Take a deep breath. Open up the top of your head and pull energy from everywhere. Morning, Mum. Down through your body, down your back, down your spine, out your feet and into the earth. Pull harder, 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 more, 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 more. More than you've ever pulled before. And as you pull, allow your body, it's very weird because you're pulling, but you're relaxing and you're expanding and you're bringing more life force energy into your body through the building you're in, out your feet and into the earth. Breathe in again. If you've got your feet on the floor, feel your feet, feel your bottom on the chair, your back against the chair. Bring that energy up and allow yourself to be this wonderful spring or fountain bubbling forth from the earth, gushing and flowing outwards. Keep expanding. Good morning, Claudia. Give your whole house a spring clean, in a sense. So float out your gold energy through the building that you're in. All the resonances or energy traces of anyone who's ever been in the house, even if they've just been visiting, anyone who's lived there, allow the gold energy to dissipate and clear all that out. The birds are having a lovely time. I don't know what's out there. So, expand, expand, expand. So anything that, I want to ask for the reasons. You are where you are right now for a whole pile of energetic contributions to occur. And whereas you may dream or plan or be asking to be somewhere else, the reality is you are where you are. So what contribution can you be to the water in your immediate vicinity, that as you be it and contribute to it, then expands out and in a way infects or changes all the other waterways and water sources? Good morning, Anne. Because that's seeing what is. And if you're willing to actually see what is, then you can ask for change. So where you are right now, absolutely fabulous, darling. How does it get any better? And have gratitude for where you be, have gratitude for the water supply that you have. If you have water tanks, take your awareness to the water tank or tanks. Detoxify all the water there. If you have water underground, which you don't even know about, running beneath your home, or chambers of water, or old springs, just detoxify it by your willingness to be the gold energy. The council or local governing bodies, water tanks, water supply, if it's a stream or a creek or a spring or a river, expand your influence out. We talk about people having spheres of influence and 6 degrees of separation and who you know and what you know, but would you be willing to expand that out to include the whole of the earth? And if you have decided that that's too much, uncreate and destroy that decision. That it would be overwhelming? Really? Okay. Uncreate and destroy that. So all the places you have barriers limiting how much you can actually create and change and generate on the planet, explode them. There is no limit to what you can be and do, have, generate, receive. Elementals, 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 assist me in purifying, enlivening, detoxifying all the water on the planet. Nature spirits, fairies, pixies, elves, water spirits, assist me, contribute to me. Ask, what's it going to take to change the water situation on the planet? What else is possible? Amazing people, some of them very young, are coming up with incredible solutions to pollution on the planet. Every time there's an oil spill or a toxic spill of any kind, what contribution can we be to them? Just by being space and asking what else is possible here. Hello, April. Hi. Expand, expand, expand. So what source and force for change, and we're going specifically with water this month, for the cleanliness, purity, pristine quality of water on the planet. Sufficiency of water for all. The availability of fresh, livened water for all on the planet. What else is possible with that? And so ask the elementals to assist you. And ask the fairies and the pixies and the elves and the dryads and the hammer dryads and the water sprites. And be willing to contribute to them, but be willing to receive from them too. Ask your team, ask the beings of light. What's it going to take for this to show up? What contribution can it be? And it starts from where you are in your home. So you be a contribution to your building, your land, the land beneath your feet, your suburb. And that doesn't necessarily mean volunteering at the local shelter. It doesn't mean anything other than you're willing to contribute and you're willing to ask the question and you're willing to hold the possibility open. How much space can you be right now? Really, even if it's intensely uncomfortable. Are you willing to get comfortable with being uncomfortable? Because the more you expand in this way, the more space you be, the more you will be aware of yucky stuff. Oh well, it will show up in your body, and the trick is not to buy it as real, or however the symptoms are showing up. Not to go into, oh no, what disease have I caught? What vitamin am I lacking? What infection do I have? Go, oh, okay, body, thank you, wow. Whew. And we know that your body can detoxify anything within about 10 minutes if you'll be in the question. I'm speaking to me here as well as you. So immediately you go to conclusion that something is showing up as something, you've locked it into your body, and it takes a while to clear it. Remember, your body is a giant organ of awareness through sensation and feeling. So if you're feeling sad or feeling sick or feeling pain, good body, thank you, thank you. What do I do with this? Can I change it? Can I expand it? Can I do 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3 on it? Thank you, body. Now, all the beings that come to you and wish to contribute and wish to give you messages, oh, look at that light. Ask them to step back a bit, give you some space. Please, everyone, step back. And you have to choose if what they have to say is relevant to you. Just because you've asked for assistance, just because you've asked for contribution, doesn't mean that you have to take notes on everything that comes in. Is it relevant? Is it for today? Is it for next week? Ask them to just step back a little bit, everybody. Give me some space here, and then expand your space out. Whatever has shifted over that Christmas period, that December 21st, 22nd, is huge. Very dynamic energy available. I just became aware of that as I'm talking to you. So what would you like to choose? What would you like to create? What would be fun for you? What is heartening for me is seeing people doing what they love brilliantly, even on a small scale. There was a lady at our local like creative artist type markets yesterday, and she just has a gift for propagating plants. She's just amazing. Her plants are healthy, and you just know that buying a plant from her, it's going to thrive. And they were not expensive, and she had so much joy. I wonder if I can show you one of the things I bought for my sister from this lady. It's just it's a succulent. She buys old bits of pottery and then repots them. Oh, there's another one of her things there, and another one there. Repots them into old containers. And the reason I say it's heartening is it reminds me that when you do what you love with this energy of woo, it changes everyone who comes in contact with you. She could have been charging twice that amount of money, but she was so happy and so excited and telling me where she found the pot, and you know, her husband drilled the hole in the bottom of it. And so what is it that you love to do, that she clearly engages the nature spirits and fairies to assist her, whether she says that or knows that? Where are you willing to show up in all your strange happiness? Expand your energy out. And if you've gone to, oh, but I don't have a talent or a capacity like that, poor me, stop it. Stop it. Expand out as big as the earth and surround the earth and waft your wonderful perfume, color, song, your energy around the earth. Wake up, people, wake up. Trees, I'm here. Plants, fields of corn, whatever it is, I'm here. Birds, woohoo. Death is not a wrongness, it's just a change. So it's okay if things are dying. It's okay, it's just a change. And if there's a place within you that there are things locked in or locked up or time locks, is it time to unlock them? Only you can do that. It will be weird. It won't feel like you. It's true. So as you go through the next 24 hours, keep expanding, keeping a contribution to the water everywhere, in your town, in your suburb, in your country. And don't shy away from intensity. Open the door and walk into intensity, whatever it is. Wherever the pain, the sadness, the anger, the misery has infected the water in the land, just go in and gently open it up. Expand, expand, expand. You can go in like the good fairy or the good witch, or you can go in as the hot smoking demon, but whatever form, however the energy is, just expand the energy, expand, expand, expand. That was then, this is now. Don't buy it, it's real. Okay, this happened, fine. What else would we like to choose? What else is possible here? How much space can I be? Okay. Remember to expand behind you. You want to keep your energy out, all sides, down into the earth above. Keep expanding. If you find any little fasteners or zips or something that's been done to your energy field to limit it, just expand out beyond it. Nothing can stop you, nothing can limit you, except you, of course. Keep going, keep going, keep going. Wonderful. Okay, talk to you all tomorrow. Bye-bye.